You're really happy
yeah,
with that?
That's amazing.
Wow. It's a work of art. The Italians have been masters of wood-fired cooking for centuries, and in Naples, the pizza has evolved to something quite extraordinary. The purest, simplest form of a food that has travelled to all corners of the earth.
In 2014, Melbourne pizzaiolo Johnny Di Francesco hit the world stage, winning the best pizza in the world amongst 600 competitors from 35 countries in Parma, Italy. He has two restaurants in Melbourne and makes up to 7,000 pizzas a week. His original restaurant in Brunswick, 400 Gradi, is named after the optimum temperature to cook pizza at 400 degrees.
This is the engine of the kitchen.
And how hot is it in there now?
That's about 430.
And I love the way that you can do it without a temperature gauge.
Yeah. We actually blow every temperature gauge that we have on the ovens.
Because you have it so hot.
Yeah.
Johnny's four ovens all come from Naples, each with a base of biscotto di Sorrento, a clay and volcanic mortar prized for its heat retention since Roman times. This and the insulated dome all help to keep the oven intensely hot for quick cooking.
There's a saying in Naples, if your pizza's not cooked within 90 seconds, then it's not a Neapolitan pizza.
Really?
Yep.
You're now going to share this world-beating recipe.
I am going to make the recipe exactly the same way that I made it on the day. We start off with water and salt first. Now, the other thing that people make a mistake is they would add the yeast now, but what that does is actually destroy the yeast. So you add about 20% of the flour first, 00 flour. We can then just drop the yeast straight in, fresh yeast.
And a tiny bit.
That's a key factor that a lot of people make a mistake on. They use a lot of yeast. And if you allow the dough to rise for the right amount of time, the yeast will release its own natural sugar and do exactly the same as adding sugar. So normally I would mix this for about 15 minutes and to tell whether the dough is ready, I then press in the centre. If it springs back up, then your dough is ready to set aside. Place it back into the bowl and just a damp cloth over the top and I'll let this rest now for 2 hours and then I'd come back to it and make my dough balls. So first one, and most people would have seen this, your normal baker would normally use this to make a dough ball. Now at home, to be able to make some dough balls and really easy, what you do is you grab it and you fold away. You then turn it up and you do the same thing again. And then you do it again. Now we'd repeat this around 6 times. So once we've done this, we then crimp the two ends like that and we fold under and we have a dough ball. From this, we will then rest for 24 hours. This is what you'd expect in 24 hours.
Gee, they really grow, don't they?
Yep.
And they're quite glossy on the outside.
Yes, they are. When we're stretching Neapolitan pizza, we want to retain all the gases or all the air in the dough. That's why you get that beautiful cornicione around the dough. Okay, so
it's the best, isn't it?
It's the best. Yes. We start from an inch from the bottom. We push and we stop. As you can see already, we then do the same thing again. And we stop. And the next technique is probably the most difficult. Place one hand on one side. We stretch. We come over to our forearm and we hold and we come back down. What I'm doing is I'm turning the pizza naturally. So then I do it again, over and back down. To get this pizza around.
I was gonna say, it must be hard for you to do it slowly because you're used to doing it quickly.
So that would be how we do it.
Johnny, the classic tomato topping.
Yeah, two ingredients, that's it. We use Sarmazzano tomato and some salt.
What sort of cheese are you?
So this is buffalo mozzarella.
From Australia?
Yes.
So you put your basil on.
So we put the basil before we cook our pizza. Also, extra virgin olive oil before, not after. So I'm gonna place this
beautiful
in the
oven.
Looks
like the Italian flag.
Yes. We then stretch it to the size that we like, and this then goes directly into the oven. We'll turn it about three times. So what I'm doing is getting the pizza cooked evenly right around.
Gee, it cooks before your eyes. Wow. It's a work of art.
I still get amazed.
Do you?
Yeah, I do. Honest. Like, especially when I see things like that. That just...
So you're really happy
yeah,
with that?
That's amazing.
So, show me how an Italian eats pizza.
So, a real Neapolitan would fold and fold this end as well.
Ah!
We've just trapped all the flavour in there.
Yum.
And that's the best part.
Okay. Johnny. Mm. It's delicious.
Thank you.
Toasty and the melted cheese, but the base wins, doesn't it? Oh.